Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad you're here. If you are visiting for the first time, consider subscribing to the channel and liking this video. If you are returning, thank you as well. Today I'm giving you a quick demo of Adobe Firefly. Adobe recently released this first beta version of this generative artificial intelligence that you can use every day in language to create extraordinary new content. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Once you have access to the beta version of Adobe Firefly, this is what it will look like. I'm going to show you two different things. First off, there's text to image and then text effects, which are available currently. So if you click on the generate button here, you'll see samples of different texts that have been generated based on what has been entered. I'm just going to go ahead and quickly show you this with my name here. So we'll put in Claudio. And let's say, for example, I want to use like a steampunk style. So let's see what happens. It's generating the text here. And over here on the right hand side, you'll see sample effects that you can choose from. But again, by entering, it generates the result that you like, and then you can rate it. And then you can click through and choose a different one or different style of generated steampunk type of text. So which that one, the AI looks a little cut off. So what I'll do is go through here and choose the one I think I like, which I think this is pretty neat. Style wise, it created really a nice effect of text. So which I kind of like that one there, and very cool. And then if you want to download it, you can click right here. You can choose to download it. There will be a watermark for this for full transparency as you are kind of sharing the content. Just know that that will be there. You can just click on continue here. So when it downloads, again, you'll see a watermark there that this was created with Adobe Firefly. All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and jump back over to the text to image portion of Adobe Firefly, which is right here. I'll click on generate. All these were generated based on what was entered in the description. Now, right now it's currently only available for English. And so when I started playing with this, I used this right here, post-apocalyptic Las Vegas backdrop, a favorite game of mine, Fallout New Vegas. I really enjoyed playing that. I thought, you know, let me play around with the different styles of effects using this. So like right now, if you notice right here, there is an art effect. I'm going to go ahead and clear the style here and just go generate and see what comes up. So here are the AI images generated based on what I entered below. I believe it's pulling these from Adobe stock images and generating these photos. So right now, if you notice right here over on the content type, it says none really. So if I go to photo, these are what are generated based on the content type. I'm going to go ahead now and add some additional styles here. So we have styles, and then we have color and tone, lighting and composition. So I'm actually going to go from this and go to art. So there's kind of an artistic look to it, and I'm going to choose all here, and I'm just going to start adding different ones one at a time, just so you can see the differences that happen. I'm in a cyberpunk mode, so I'm going to go ahead and click on cyberpunk, and then I'll click on generate, and let's see what happens. So now here are the results based on adding that cyberpunk style there. So I'm going to go ahead now and come down here to some other sections. So we have themes, and let's see, let's go down to techniques. Maybe there was one that I kind of liked, let's see here, which I thought was right here, bioluminescence. I'm going to choose that one and click on generate. So every time I add, you notice the image is getting a little more detail, a different look to it, to this backdrop. And let me go and see. I think it's up here at the top. What I'm trying to find is, even though it kind of looks chaotic already, but I'm going to add the chaotic effect here, which I think is somewhere down here. Let's try to find it here. Concepts, here we go, chaotic. Let's click on that and hit generate and see what happens. And here we have it with chaotic added to it. As you can see, every time I add something, the picture just keeps getting a little more drastically, in this case, chaotic. So now what I'm going to do is add some lighting here. So you have these lighting effects. I'm going to choose this dramatic lighting and then hit generate and see what happens now. All right, and there we have with dramatic lighting, and I think I'm going to add some vibrancy to this. So I add a color and tone, vibrant color, and click generate, and let's see what happens. And with that vibrant color, it just really popped out that pink and orange and blues, purples there in this photo. Looks really cool. I'm really liking the way this is looking. And I think one of the last things I will check here is composition. So you can choose how this photo or this art piece will look like. We have different types of, let's see, wide angle, shot from above, narrow depth of field. I just want to check a few of these out. Let's try wide angle and then hit generate. And here's with the wide angle composition added here. And now I'm going to do one last thing here. And if you notice the content type, out of curiosity, I'm just going to click on photo and see what happens. Switching from art to photo, these look a lot more photorealistic. Still have a lot of that vibrancy, dramatic look because I entered that in the effects and styles. The last photo here, you can see that water to me that really popped as soon as it came up. It looks real, you know, like there's a water there that was left over post-apocalyptic in Las Vegas. And this basically what I entered, it's fitting the style that I want. If you want to download any of the AI generated images, just hover over, choose that download, and then you'll have it on your computer. And then the button over here, there's some options you can check out. But once you are given access, give it a try and then let me know what you think. I hope you've enjoyed this demo of Adobe Firefly. If you're interested in giving it a try, check out adobe.com/Firefly. You can request access to this beta version and just know that there are lots of requests. So just be patient as they go through all those thousands of requests. If you have any comments or questions about this video, please drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.